Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you another new feature in Stata 16, meta-analysis. Meta-analysis in Stata 16 begins with either the meta-e-size or meta-set commands. Meta-e-size allows you to compute and declare effect sizes for continuous or binary outcomes, or you can use meta-set to declare pre-computed effect sizes. You can fit common effect models, fixed effects models, or random effects models using a variety of estimation methods. You can create summary tables and forest plots, and you can do this by subgroup if you like, or you can create Labbé plots, fit meta-regression models, create funnel plots, test for small study effects, or conduct non-parametric trim and fill analysis of publication bias. Let's look at an example using data from a study of the effects of teacher expectancy on pupil IQ. You can download this dataset by typing webuse pupil IQ. This dataset includes variables such as the standardized difference in means, the standard error of the standardized difference in means, there's a variable for study label, there's also an indicator variable for prior teacher-student contact being greater than 1 week, and then we also have the actual number of weeks of prior to teacher-student contact. So we can begin our meta-analysis by going to Statistics and scrolling down to Meta-Analysis. This will open the Meta-Analysis Control Panel. We begin our meta-analysis at the top here using Setup. This is where we declare our data to be meta-analysis data. And this is the first step in our meta-analysis. It helps us minimize mistakes and it saves you time because you specify the required information such as effect sizes and their standard errors only once, and then it's used automatically throughout the rest of your meta-analysis session. If you have summary data for each study such as means and standard deviations, or if you have for instance, the number of successes and failures for binary data, you can use Stata to compute and then declare the effect size of interest. In our case, we already have pre-computed effect sizes in our data set, so I'm going to select this bottom option here, Declare Generic Pre-computed Effect Sizes. So then I'm going to select the effect size, which is stored as the standardized mean difference, and then I'm going to select the standard error, which is right here, SE, and then I'm going to click on Model, and Random Effects is the default. And then I can select other estimation techniques right here if I want to. And then I'm going to click Options and specify the study label right here. So once I'm ready, I can click Submit. And this will issue the command meta-set. And the standardized mean difference is our effect size. And then we also have our standard error of our effect size. The study label variable is study LBL. And then if we look at our output, we can see all the features of our meta-analysis data. If I want to, I can go back and modify that later by clicking Modify Meta Settings, and I can go back and change some of these attributes if I want to. Next, I'm going to go to Summary, and here I can summarize my meta-analysis data if I like, and I'm just going to leave everything at the default and click Submit. And if I look over here in the results window and scroll up, I can see that Stata has issued the command meta summarize, the dialog box, has issued the command meta summarize. And below this, I can see the number of studies, some statistics about the heterogeneity among the studies. I can see a list of the studies as well as the effect size and confidence interval for each of them, as well as the percentage of weight given to each of the studies in my meta-analysis. And then at the bottom, I can see my test of theta equal to zero. Theta, of course, is our overall effect size for combined effect size. And then I also see a test of homogeneity here at the bottom. So then if I want to go, I can go back to the meta-analysis control panel and select forest plots. And I'm going to begin by just leaving everything at with the default, including the declared model, and click submit. And this will create a forest plot for us. The command back here in the results window is meta forest plot. And here we see essentially the same information that we saw in our summary table, except it includes a graph here in the middle. And of course, this green diamond here at the bottom is our overall measure of effect size. If I wanted to, I could do this by study. So for example, I could do a subgroup analysis by checking this box next to subgroup meta-analysis, and then I could select the variable week 1, which is an indicator for the student-pupil contact being greater than 1 week. If I click submit, I'm going to just move this over so we can see the command. The command now includes the option comma subgroup week 1, and now I can see my forest plot by students, by studies with student-teacher contact less than or equal to 1 week or greater than 1 week. Okay. Another thing that I could do if I wanted to is I could compute, or I could create a cumulative meta-analysis forest plot. So I'm going to order the studies by another variable. In this case, I'm going to order them by the actual weeks of student-teacher contact. So I'm going to click submit. And here I can see in the far right-hand column the number of actual weeks of student-teacher contact for each of the studies. And I can actually see a bit of a trend here that as the number of weeks of contact increases, the effect size actually gets smaller. The last thing I'm going to do here for this example is click on regression, and I can fit a meta-regression model, and I'm going to include the covariate weeks in my model and leave everything else where it's set at the default and click submit. And now if I look over at the results window, I can see the command is meta-regress, weeks is the covariate, and if I look at the coefficient here at the bottom, I can see that the effect sizes are decreasing as weeks increases. Okay, let's switch data sets so that I can show you some of the features for exploring publication bias. This is a study of the effectiveness of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. You can download this data set by typing WebUse NSAIDs set. And here in the description of the data, I can see that there are some binary variables or counts of successes. So I have the number of successes in the treatment arm, the number of failures in the treatment arm, the number of successes in the control arm, and the number of failures in the control arm. I can also tell that these data have already been declared as meta-analysis data because of this group of variables here at the bottom that begin with underscore meta. The other clue that they've already been set is the description of the data set says set with meta e size. And then another way I can explore that is to type meta query, and this will show me the details of my meta-analysis settings. So to explore publication bias, I'm going to go to statistics and select meta-analysis. And because we've already set our data, I'm just going to go to publication bias here at the bottom. And I want to begin with funnel plots, and I'm just going to create a standard funnel plot. That's the default. So I'm going to click submit. And this will create a funnel plot. On the horizontal axis, we have the log odds ratio. And then on the vertical axis, we have the standard error. And we can see that there's an asymmetry to our funnel plot here. And so we want to maybe explore that further. One way to enhance that is to add contours. So I'm going to go back to the control panel and select contour enhanced funnel plot. And I might like to see this for 1%, 5%, and 10% significant levels. And I'm going to click submit again, and this will add contours to my funnel plot. Okay, so I'm going to close that. Another thing I can do is test for small study effects and meta-analysis. Again, I'm just going to leave everything at the default. There are a variety of tests that I can use here if I want, but I'm just going to click submit and use the defaults. The command here is meta bias, and then the option Eger tests for small study effects. By the way, I forgot to mention here, the command for creating the funnel plot is meta funnel plot, and then I've also added the option contours 1, 5, 10. Lastly, I might want to perform a non-parametric trim and fill analysis of publication bias, so I'm just going to select that and click submit, and this will issue the command meta trim fill, and this will perform our non-parametric trim and fill analysis. So these are some of the things that you can do with the new meta-analysis features in Stata 16. If you'd like to learn more, you can visit our website. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.